Hello and welcome. This is another album review on Sound of Ominous, and today we will review the third studio album by the thrash and death metal Brazilian legends, Sepultura. I did review their last record in a previous episode and I did merely enjoy that record. It's a very underrated Sepultura album in my opinion. So definitely check that one out if you haven't already. This is their follow-up album and this is basically where Sepultura opened the doors for themselves for mainstream culture. Although this is a very heavy album, but I do think that they did really manage to open up the gates with this record and really did some groundbreaking things on this record, you know, blending thrash and death metal to a perfect teat in a way. We have 9 tracks on this album, 12 if you want to, you know, count the, the drum tracks, Inner Self and Mass Hypnosis, but I don't really do that. Which are already tracks on the album, mind you, but those are basically just Igor solo tracks, drum tracks. And we have Aurora e Vesdu Sabelo Nasquer, which is written by Almovo Lima Filho, which also never heard of one before. Have not really intention to do so, so there we go. Just basically like a cover song, I think. So we will focus on the 9 main songs. This is by the way a request about Rockdo, which I didn't say in the previous episode. And I also think I didn't say that Phantom requested those Nightwish albums. I believe I didn't say that too, but you know, there you go. So we start off with the title track, which is written by Igor, Max, Paolo Jr., Andreas Kisser. So I think the whole band. Yeah, there we go. Very awesome track, you know, it starts off kind of mellow and kind of like silent with that, you know, with that kind of lullaby kind of vibe. It's very interesting, then it goes into that pulse pounding heavy riff beat that you're kind of were getting warm to on Schizophrenia, but Schizophrenia, there you go. But you really got the full package here on Beneath the Remains. Very awesome track, it's 5 minutes and 14 seconds long. It's just a perfect length, perfect thrash. I mean, it's one of those like perfect ways to start out with thrash metal or death metal for that matter. They're really 50-50 in a way, I think, you know. It's just a perfect opening track. I have not really a lot to say here. The song really speaks for itself. Check it out, it's a classic. Then we have the second song, which is Inner Self. I really love the pulse pounding riffs on this record. It does really sound like, you know, they're getting into more groovier and groovier stuff. It does remind me a lot of Chaos AD, because the riffs are just really groovy and, you know, and, you know, when they kind of do that that pause right there, you know that. And then they go into the riff, you know, it's just so catchy. It's just such a memorable riff. The vocals are great. The drum pauses are amazing. I mean, this is just an even better follow-up song. These are pretty much 2 of the most like iconic Sepultura songs ever. Check them out if you haven't already. Yeah, it's just basically what I said about Beneath the Remains. It really doesn't need an explanation. It's just such a classic. Then we have Stronger Than Hate, a lot of like epic natures on this track. This is the longest track, by the way. 5 minutes and 53 seconds. 5 minutes and 50 seconds on all music. It's 3 seconds longer for some reason. But I do really like this song right here. It's written by Kelly Shaver, whoever that is. I have no clue, but I do really like the lyrics here. You know, they're talking about that the feeling they have maybe for like politics and maybe like the country's ambassador or like the leader of the country of Brazil or, you know, whatever they're talking about. You know, they have a stronger feeling than hate, which is very extreme, mind you. It's just a very heavy track. The length perfectly encapsulates how much Sepultura wants to accomplish this thing that they're trying to reach. It's just perfect trash. It's perfect. It is a perfect length. I love the lyrics by Kelly Shaver. Just a lot of great songwriting on this track. I do think that he or she, you know, Kelly, can be interpreted as both male and female. But I don't fucking know. But I do just really like the lyrics on there. I do really like the song. It's just a classic trash track, and I love it. Speaking of classic trash, we have Mass Hypnosis. I just love whenever Cavalera shouts, Mass Hypnosis, you know, whenever he shouts that, you know, I just love that. I also love that this song is kind of more melodic, kind of more mellow, but also it's just, you know, not any song is really too mellow on this track. It's just perfect, you know, kind of balls to the wall power trash, you know, it's just... you know, on 110%, it's just one of those really hypnotic tracks. It's really catchy yet really heavy, so it's just a perfect mix of both, and you know, makes for a perfect song once again. Then we have Sarcastic Existence, which is just a powerful track. I love the title already, Sarcastic Existence, which just sounds just very funny in my opinion. Just like you know, Sepultura is laughing at the people that are, you know, are having a sarcastic existence, because, you know, they think they have a great life, but they don't. They, you know, Sepultura thinks it sucks, which is very relatable for me. It's probably one of my personal favorite Sepultura tracks. It's just very, like, the lyrics again are really powerful. It's a really, you know, great title, I think. The song is just very classic. I just really love it. It's the centerpiece of the record, so another classic track. Then we have Slaves of Pain. I just really love the kind of riff on this track again. The lyrics are great, you know. Feeling pain, do-ga-do, 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 slaves of pain. And then the drum fill by Igor Cavalera. You know, those drum, those cymbal crashes. I just love it, man. I mean, it's just great. It's just such a catchy track. It's kind of reminds you of Inner Self 0.2, you know, but I'm not saying Volume 2, I guess, which kind of makes it better. But I do think the songs are equal. I do think the both songs are really great. I cannot really choose. Then we have Lobotomy, which is a very heavy subject. If you don't know what a lobotomy is, then I've actually recently discovered this, but you know, it was a way in, like, I believe the early 20th century where people, well, I'm not gonna explain it because that's a bit too vulgar for my channel, but you can look it up. I mean, it's everywhere, come on now. Not anymore, but on the internet, a lot. You know, enough people talk about it, so there we go. But mind you, it's something here. Something is happening here, so there we go. But that's a bit too vulgar for my channel, I would say, so let's not go there. But Lobotomy, this is a very vulgar track. I do really love the kind of mellow, kind of dark nature of this track. It does kind of remind me of Beneath the Remains Part 2. And I do think the band, you know, not that I mind, you know, I do still really love this record, but I do think that the band is kind of like, you know, they made a kind of Inner Self Part 2, they kind of make a Beneath the Remains Part 2 here, because this song is very dark and very moody and kind of like mellow. But I do think they kind of slightly improve upon the tracks, you know, they do kind of do the same thing again, but I don't mind it, since it makes the record more consistent. And you're improving over what you've already achieved, so it's just fantastic. You know, some people are probably gonna, you know, criticize that, but I just love it, man. Lobotomy, just perfect track, perfect length, perfect trash, just perfect death growls in a way. I just love it, man. I mean, I cannot really explain this song. This is kind of like the Inquisition Symphony of the album. It is just one of those tracks that you really have to look out for yourself. It's just fantastic. And then we have Hungry, which is kind of like, you know, I don't want to make fun of this song, but I actually was really hungry while listening to this song. I just, you know, ate some grapes and I was just like, fuck me, I'm hungry. And, you know, then I was listening to this song. It's just very funny. It's a very, very serious song, you know. The lyrics, once again, I do think that Max Cavalera is a really great songwriter, you know, in Soulfly and Cavalera Conspiracy. I'm a big fan of Max Cavalera. I love that guy. I mean, he's just so chill. Whenever he's in an interview, you know, it just looks like he smoked a whole tree or something. It just looks so chill, man. I love that guy. And Igor, for that matter, too. I love the Cavalera Brothers, Cavalera Conspiracy. Come on now. Just a very primitive track, very essential for listening, and not a classic. And speaking of primitive, we have Primitive Future, which is just kind of like, again, one of those Damage Inc, Dire's Eve kind of songs. You know, Sepultura always know how to close their albums out with a perfect trash masterpiece, which is Primitive Future. The song is just balls to the wall, full-blown trash metal, you know. It's just one of those great tracks where Cavalera screams, Primitive Future. And I believe he does it at the beginning and at the end of the track. And then at the ending, you get sort of like this very strange, mellow, ominous kind of sound, which also was on the beginning. So Sepultura is kind of trying to make this a concept album, which, you know, it's going back to the beginning, so you play the record over and over again. It's really not, you know, it's actually now that I, you know, that I realized that I actually realized that the spooky kind of ominous vibe was on the ending of the album and on the beginning of the album. So, yeah, you know, I actually do see what Sepultura did there like 2 years later, but I mean, I guess, you know, better late than never. But overall, I just fucking love this album. It's just a perfect trash death metal album. And although I do think that Schizophrenia is a really underrated record and you should definitely check that out, I do think that if you want to start with Sepultura, well, maybe start with Chaos ID because that's less heavier. But if you're used to heavy metal, then I would say start out with Beneath the Remains, because every song front to back, it's flawless. I mean, come on now, it's just a fucking perfect trash piece. Yeah, that's just what it is, man. I mean, they kind of did the same on Arise, but I do think that the songs on that album are a little bit better. But this album is just so consistent, just fucking hell, man. I mean, you cannot give this album like any other rating than a 10 out of 10, because it's just perfect. I mean, every song on this album, Beneath the Remains is a classic, Inner Self is a classic, Stronger Than Hate is one of my personal favorites, Massive Nose is a classic, Sarcastic Existence is another personal favorite of mine, Slaves of Pain is a classic, Lobotomy is a classic, Hungry is great, very deep track, and Primitive Future is a perfect closing track. So 10 out of 10, I love this album. I mean, come on now, it's a classic. It's a classic, so there we go. I hope you've enjoyed this album review by me, of course, by Ominous. You know, from the record. Well, it's kind of going downhill now, really. But let me know what you think about the record, Beneath the Remains by Sepultura, their third studio album, their major label debut, I guess. Yeah, it is probably like their major label debut. There we go. So, let me know what you think about their major label debut. Fucking hell, their major label debut. Let me know what you think about it. What is your favorite Sepultura album? Cavalera era, of course, because what else? You fucking dipshit. But let me know what you think about it. Let me know what is your favorite one. Let me know what is your favorite Sepultura song. Of course, from the classic era. From the only era. I mean, come on now. Let me know those things in the comments down below. I will happily read them, and I'll see you in the next video. God bless. God damn it. Peace, guys. Do I want to say something? Well, yeah, you know Sepultura rules, but I just fucking suck with these fucking outros. Fucking.